was an early morning barroom, and the place just opened up. Little man came in so fast and started at his cups. And the broad who served the whiskey, she was a big old friendly girl who tried to fight her empty nights by smiling at the world. And she said, "Hey, bub, it's been a while since you've been around. Where the hell you been hiding? Why you look so down?" But the little man just sat there like he'd never heard a sound. Waitress, she gave out a cough, and acting not the least put off, she spoke once again. She said, "I don't want to bother you. Consider it understood. I know I'm not no beauty queen, but I sure can listen good." And the little man took a drink in his hand and he raised it to his lips. He took a couple of sips and he told the waitress this story. "I am the midnight watchman down at Miller's Tool and Die. And I watch the metal rusting and I watch the time go by. A week ago at the diner I stopped to get a bite. And this here lovely lady, she sat two seats from my right. Lord, 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 she was all right. See, she was so damn beautiful, she could warm a winter's frost. And she was long past lonely and well nigh unto lost. Now I'm not much of a mover or a pick-em-up easy guy, so I decided to glide on over and give her one good try. So Lord, 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 she was worth a try. I was tongue-tied like a schoolboy, stammered out some words. But it did not seem to matter much, 'cause I don't think she heard. Just looked clear on through me to a space back in my head. Shamed me into silence, as quietly she said, 'If you want me to come with you, well, that's all right with me. I know I'm going nowhere, anywhere's a better place to be.'" Drove her to my boarding house and I took her up to my room. I went to turn on the only light to brighten up the gloom, but she said, "Please leave the light on. Oh, I don't mind the dark." As her clothes all tumbled around her, I could hear my heart. Light shone upon her as she lay back in my bed. It was the kind of scene I only had imagined in my head. I just could not believe it, to think that she was real. As I tried to tell her, she said, "You just have me." "But if you want to come here with me, then that's all right with me. 'Cause I've been oh so lonely, loving someone is a better way to be." morning came so swiftly while I held her in my arms. And she slept like a baby, snug and safe from harm. Did not want to share her with the world or break the mood. So before she woke, I went out, got us both some food. Came back with my paper bag to find that she was gone. She'd left a 6-word letter saying it's time that I moved on. So the waitress took her bar rag and she wiped it across her eyes. And as she spoke, her voice came out as something like a sigh. She said, I wish that I were beautiful, or that you were halfway blind. I wish I weren't so goddamn fat, and I wish that you were mine. And I wish that you'd come with me when I leave for home. As we both know all about emptiness, living all alone. And the little man looked at the empty glass in his hand, and he smiled a crooked grin. He said, I guess I'm out of gin, and I know we both have been so lonely. And if you want me to come with you, that's alright with me. Cause I know I'm going nowhere, anywhere's a better place.
I want to be alone. had the flu. It's sure nice talking to you, Dad. It's been sure nice talking to you. And as I hung up the phone, it occurred to me you'd grown up just like me. My boy was just like me.
Have a good time. Thank you, Marcy Geller and the ensemble.
Well, my child arrived just the other day. He came to the world in the usual way, but there were planes to catch, bills to pay. He'd learned to walk while I was away, and he was talking for I knew him. And as he grew, he said, I'm gonna be like you, Dad. You know I'm gonna be like you. And the cat's in the cradle and a silver spoon, little boy blue and the man in the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when, but we'll get together then, yeah. You know we'll have a good time then. Well, my son turned 10 just the other day. Said, thanks for the ball, Dad, come on, let's play. Can you teach me to throw? Said, not today, I got a lot to do. He said, that's okay, and he walked away, but his smile never dimmed. He said, I'm gonna be like him, yeah. You know I'm gonna be like him. And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon, little boy blue and the man in the moon. When you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when, but we'll get together then. You know we'll have a good time then. Well, he came from college just the other day, so much like a man I just had to say. Son, I'm proud of you. You sit for a while. He shook his head and he said with a smile, what I'd really like, Dad, is to borrow the car keys. See you later, can I have them, please? And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon, little boy blue and the man in the moon. When you're coming home, son, I don't know when, but we'll get together then. You know we'll have a good time then. Since retired, my son's moved away. I called him up just the other day. I said, I'd like to see you if you don't mind. He said, I'd love to, Dad, if I could find the time. You see, the new job's a hassle and the kids got the flu, but it's sure nice talking to you, Dad. It's sure nice talking to you. And as I hung up the phone, it occurred to me, he'd grown up just like me. My boy was just like me. And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon, the little boy blue and the man in the moon. When you're coming home, and I don't know when, but we'll get together then, yeah. You'll know we'll have a good time then. And the cat's in the cradle and the silver spoon, little boy blue and the man in the moon. Yeah, when you're coming home, Dad, I don't know when, but we'll get together then. You know we'll have a good time then.
Who, if it were based on talent alone, would be in the show. However, I set a rule when we first started doing this that it would be Long Islanders leading leading all the songs at least. And she's from New Jersey, but she's a great folk singer and performer. And my band Gathering Time is proud to play with her quite a bit. She's acting as stage mom, getting people organized. Her name is Mara Levine. She's back there somewhere. There she is. Next up is a group made up from the left. We have Susan Ernst on guitar, Laura Kendall on the fiddle. She was just playing with Robin also. We've got Ken the Rocket Cord on harmonica and vocals, and the, should we call you peripatetic? The constant presence, the biggest Harry Chapin fan of the bunch, Frank Walker, playing bass. On a song that I like very, very much. In fact, I've performed it. Please welcome Friends on the Journey.
She holds you, she enfolds you in her world. The first time I saw Harry Chapin was when he and his band played a concert in November 1976 at St. Vincent College in Latrobe, Pennsylvania. I became a lifelong fan that night, and the band played this song that night, and it's been one of my favorite songs ever since. It's called Corey's Coming. Old John Joseph was a man with two first names. They left him in the railroad yard when they took away the trains. And only one run a week comes on roaring down that line. So all he's got to worry about is time. He sits in the brake house, his hands out to the fire, moving through his memories of love and desire. Telling me the stories of the glories of his past, but he always saves the story of his Corey for the last. And he says, my Corey's coming, no more sad stories coming, my midnight, moonlight, morning glory's coming on you, girl. And like I told you, when she holds you, she enfolds you in her world. I'd come by in the evening, find out where he'd been, and he'd say, come on, sit down, kid, where shall I begin? And I'd say, you know my favorites, though you know I like the rest, but I love the way you tell me of your Corey the best. And so I'd hear his lifelong love recreated by his tongue. He'd turn back the years, she'd seem forever young. And though the other stories changed as they rolled through his head, he'd say the same words about Corey just before he went to bed. And then he'd send me away, but he'd be smiling as he said, can't you see my Corey's coming? No more sad stories coming, my midnight, moonlight, morning glory's coming on, girl. And like I told you, when she holds you, she enfolds you in her world. Well, I was quite surprised to find out all the places that he knew. So I asked the townsfolk if his stories were true. They said old John was born here, he's lived here all his life. He's never had a woman, let alone a wife. And very soon you'll find out, as you check around, that no one named Corey's ever lived in this town. So I chided the old man about the truth that I had heard. He smiled and said, reality is only just a word. Can't you see my Corey's coming? No more sad stories coming. My midnight, moonlight, morning glory's coming, aren't you, girl? And like I told you, when she holds you, she enfolds you in her world. I came by one evening, but he did not hear my shout. I looked in the window and I saw the fire was out. When he would not wake up, I forced in the door, and I found that old John Joseph would tell stories no more. There was a scene at the graveyard, just three of us were there. There was me and the grave digger, and we heard the parson's prayer. He said, we need not grieve for this man, for we know that God cares. They put the cold dirt over him and left me on my own. When at last I looked up, I saw I was not alone. Standing there in silence with a shawl around her head was a beautiful young woman. I remember what she said. Is that John Joseph there? I nodded my head, yes. That brought a soft smile from her. She said, it's time he got some rest. So I said, if you're a relative, he had a peaceful end. That's when she said, my name is Corey. You could say I'm just a friend. Corey's coming. No more sad stories coming. My midnight, moonlight, morning glories coming, aren't you, girl? Listen, like I told you, when she holds you, she enfolds you in her world. Well, that's the old man's story. I'm glad you came tonight. You see, a busted down old railroad yard sure makes a lonely sight. You may wonder why a young man would work out here alone. Well, the job pays enough to keep some flesh on my bones. And I confess I get to missing the old man a bit. Yes, there's one other reason I guess I could admit. Can't you see my Corey's coming? No more sad stories coming. My midnight, moonlight, morning glory's coming, not you, girl. Yes, and like he told me, when she holds me, she enfolds me in her world.
Thanks, Harry. And remember, when in doubt, do something.
There you stand in your dungarees, looking all grown up and so very pleased.
When you write your poems, they have so much to say. When you speak your dreams, it takes my breath away.
You know I wanna be a ball player, a regular slugging fool. But both our dreams must wait a while until we finish school.
And so you and I, we'll watch our years go by. We'll watch our sweet dreams fly far away. But maybe someday, I don't know when, but we will dream again, and we'll be happy then,
till our time just drifts away. There you stand in your wedding dress, you're so beautiful that I must confess. I'm so proud you have chosen me, when a doctor is what you wanna be.
You know I wanna be a painter, dear, a real artistic snob. But I guess we'll have our children first, you stay at home, I'll get a job. And so you and I, we'll watch our years go by. We'll watch our sweet dreams fly far away. But maybe someday, don't know when, but we will dream again, and we'll be happy then, till our time just drifts away.
Listen to the children laughing.
Where do broken dreams go? There you stand in your tailored suit. So many years gone by, but you're still so cute. Take the car to go and meet the bus when our grandson comes to visit us.
Say you should have been a ballerina, babe. There are songs I should have sung. But I guess our dreams have come and gone. You gotta dream when you are young.
And so you and I, we've watched our years go by. We've watched our sweet dreams fly far away. But maybe someday, don't know when, but we will dream again, and we'll be happy then,
till
our time
just drifts away.
empty closet, empty heart, empty morning. Day won't start. Well, I got no place to go now. I really do not know how to lock my life now that you're gone. Empty mailbox, an empty head, empty promise in an empty bed. Well, I really can't believe in the thought of you just leaving, but there's no one here, and you must be gone. Guess I took you for granted, thought of us as one, but now the laugh's on me, cause your head for me just took off with the sun. Empty pocket, an empty day, empty feeling won't go away. Well, I never meant to use you, thought of just to abuse you, and there's no one here now that you're gone. I guess I took you for granted, I thought of us as one, but now the laugh's on me, cause your half of me just took off with the sun. Empty closet, empty heart, empty morning, day won't start. Well, I got no place to go now. I really do not know how to lock my life now that you're gone. I got an empty closet, got an empty heart, got an empty icebox, and this day won't start. I gotta keep on moving, cause I'm leaving too. Bye, 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 baby, there's no one left for you. I'm packing my bags, leaving town. Bye, 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 baby. Because you're gone.
Thank you. Thank you, Harry.
Barefoot down below.
Yeah.
Accompanied Frank Walker on the right, playing guitar there, Judy Palma on the piano.
Yes,
and
I!
Mueller on cello.
I cannot.
Woo!
Please welcome Rob and Eve.
Yeah, Robin!
There we go.
We were going to do a little introduction of the song, but we realized that it's pretty self-explanatory, so this is what I was ordering.
Oh,
There are so many colors in the flowers, so let's use every one. But a little more painted flowers in a rose and green and red. And when the teacher asked him why, this is what he said. He said, flowers are red. There are so many colors in the rainbow, so many colors in the morning sun, so many colors in the flowers, and I see
flowers are green and red. There's a time to show their thinking man and a way they should be done. You got to show concern for everyone else, for you're not the only one. And she said, flowers are red, young man, green leaves are green. There's no need to see flowers any other way than the way they always have been seen.
But the little boy said,
thank you. flowers any other way than the way they always have been seen. But there still must be a way to have our children say, there's so many colors in the rainbow, so many colors in the morning sun, so many colors in the flower, and I see everyone.
Little boy went first day of school. He got some crayons and he started to draw. He put colors all over the paper, for colors was what he saw. The teacher said, "What you doing, young man?"
"I'm painting flowers,"
he said. She said, "It's not the time for art, young man. And anyway, flowers are green and red. There's a time for everything, young man, and a way it should be done. You've got to show concern for everyone else, for you're not the only one." And she said, "Flowers are red, young man. Green leaves are green. There's no need to see flowers any other way than the way they always have been seen." But the little boy said,
"There's so many colors in the rainbow. There's so many colors in the morning sun. There's so many colors in a flower, and I see everyone."
The teacher said, "You're sassy. There's ways that things should be, and you'll paint flowers the way they are, so repeat after me." And she said, "Flowers are red, young man. Green leaves are green. There's no need to see flowers any other way than the way they always have been seen." But the little boy said again,
"There are so many colors in the rainbow. There's so many colors in the morning sun. There are so many colors in the flower, and I see everyone."
The teacher put him in a corner and said, "It's for your own good, and you won't come out till you get it right and responding like you should." Well, finally he got lonely, frightened thoughts that filled his head, and he went up to the teacher, and this is what he said. And he said,
"Flowers are red, green leaves are green. There's no need to see flowers any other way than the way they always have been seen."
Time went by like it always does, and they moved to another town. The little boy went to another school, and this is what he found. The teacher there was smiling. She said, "Painting should be fun, and there are so many colors in the flower, so let's use everyone." But that little boy painted flowers in neat rows of green and red. When the teacher asked him why, this is what he said. And he said,
"Flowers are red, green leaves are green. Flowers any other way than the way they always have been seen."
But oh, if there was still some way to have our children say,
"There's so many colors in the rainbow. There's so many colors in the morning sun. There's so many colors in a flower, and I see everything."
good. Thanks for watching, everybody.
Can't you see? by the time I was 13, started taking shape. At 18 I was so beautiful that the strangers started to gape. I said enter the ultimate contest, but you're as gorgeous as you see. I said please, 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 we are American dreams. But late that night beneath the gleaming moon, there's a dazzling sight in my motel room. For a fronting judge with his bulging eyes, I give my all for a share of pride. Oh, why? Oh, why? I miss America. Crying on TV. Silver clad in satin rags. But everything's where it should be. I'll say, can you see? I'll say, can you see? After they showed me the game ball, they told me put on weight. They told me I'd be powerful. They told me I'd be great. And my Uncle Sam would coach me, his helmet's on my head. They said please, 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 when it beat the spread. But the new game plan that the owners had made meant that win or lose, they would feel the parade. For the team become a real gold mine, and the kids sold off for the bottom line. Oh, why? Oh, why? Mr. America, sweating on TV, the winner's joy from the battered boy, but everything's where it should be. Oh, say, can you see? Oh, say, can you see? At last we've come together. Call it marriage or civil war. If it brings us to battle, baby, it must be worth our fighting for. Came up loudy, but there will be other days. They said, please, 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 what else is there to say? But in a plywood spread by a plastic stream, and a separate bed with a borrowed dream, and the question quiet and the silence deep. We take two pills so at last we'll sleep. Oh, why? Oh, why? Mr. and Mrs. America, our stories on TV. Can you hear cat laughter? For everything's where it should be. I'll say, can you see? I'll say, can you see? Well, my little boy, he told me something just the other night. He whispered it as I kissed him before I turned out the light. And of course he said it simple, as only children can. He said, Daddy, 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 please, I'm ready to dream again. Thank you.
I wonder.
Well, I wonder. Well, I wonder. Yes, I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
What would happen? What would happen, to this world?
Well, I wonder what would happen to this world. Yes, I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
What would happen?
Yes, I wonder.
What would happen,
yes,
to this world?
I wonder what would happen to this world.
Now if a man tried to use his time on earth before he died, but one man's life could be worth,
I wonder what would happen to this world.
And if a woman, she used a lifetime,
I wonder what would happen to this world.
Ooh, I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
What would happen?
Yes, I wonder.
What happened?
Yes, I wonder. I wonder what would happen to this world.
Ooh,
I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
What would happen
to this world?
As I look around me, there are strange things. There's muggers and there's drunkards.
We are lit by clowns.
If the answer ever found us, would it change things? Or are we just the people running for the ground? Oh, we see them marching down. Do we join the parade? Do we try to sit down?
I wonder what would happen to this world.
I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
I wonder what would happen to this world.
As I look around me, there are strange things. There's mothers and there's jugglers.
We are left back alone.
If the answer ever found us, would it change things? Or are we just the people running ready for the ground?
If our people took their time on earth to prove before we die, well, one life could be worth.
I wonder what would happen to this world.
Well, I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
Yes, I wonder.
What would happen?
Yes, I wonder.
What would happen,
yes,
to this world?
Life that the lovers got to learn.
to earth. In the years where you began to fight, you know you got to earth. You try to look, but you won't touch. And you won't touch, but you'll never feel.
Songwriter and song interpreter who also has what I know you're going to think is a beautiful voice. Being joined here in singing one of Harry's lesser known songs, and she's being joined by Frank Walker, Sue Marcus, and Lisa and Tony Vernola, please welcome Christine Solomino.
Thank you. Baby, baby, it's the last band. Last song from the last band. The last note from the last man. Give it all you can. Cards came down to the last deal. Starving man in his last meal. Movies down to the last reel. With an ending you never planned. She's left you now, so it seems. Tumbling down the last tree. Finding out that final dream can disappear so fast. Watch it all just fade away. Coming down to the last day. The last stop, the last place. And you're alone at last. So you circle all the wagons and you hide behind.
Think it could be you, but you're the only one that got off the train. So you must be my wife, Miss Annie Halsey. Yes, yes, I must be your husband. Hello, I'm Harry Crane. Mail order Annie. Never mind your crying. Your tears are sweet rain in my empty life. Mail order Annie, can't you see I'm trying to tell you that I'm glad you're here. You who are the woman who's come to be my wife. You know you're not as pretty as I dreamed you'd be. But then I'm not no handsome fancy Dan. But out here looks are really not important. No, no. It's what's inside a woman when she's up against the land. Order Annie, never mind your crying. Your tears are sweet rain in my empty life. Mail order Annie, can't you see, I'm trying to tell you that I'm glad you're here. You who are the woman who's come to be my wife. You know it's not no easy life you're entering. The winter wind comes whistling through the cracks there in the sod. You know you'll never have too many neighbors. There's you, babe, and there's me, and there's God. Just a dirt man from the North Dakota plains. You're one girl from the city who's been thrown out on her own. And I'm standing here not sure of what to say to you. Except in mail order, Annie, let's you and me. Never mind your crying, your tears are sweet rain in my empty life. Mail order Annie, can't you see I'm trying to tell you that I'm glad you're here. You who are the woman who's come to be my wife.
You're going to recognize three out of the four faces coming up right now. Frank Walker has a habit of surrounding himself with beautiful women who have big voices. Next performer has been playing professionally for about 5 years. He's become a welcome part of the Long Island folk and songwriter and even rock communities. She's got a CD set to come out in the fall. As soon as we get a mic on her. While we're waiting for that, I'd like to say, if anybody saw this in Newsday or any of the local papers, there's a guy named Mike Kornfeld, who's a freelance publicity PR person, did an awful great job helping us publicize this show, and from the size of this crowd, you can tell he did a great job. And also, if you didn't pick up the program, if you want to experience this again, it is being live webcast right now, and it will be archived by a man named Marvin Bizzura. The website is www.b2bvid.com. It's a business-to-business video site. But you can enjoy this all over again. We've got some friends in foreign cities doing it. Are you ready, guys? Please welcome, accompanied by Frank, Paulie, and Mike, and Howard, Robin Eve.
Neighbors praise the boy, support our funnest growth.
They said that he should use his gift instead of cleaning coats. Oh, Paul, on your music was his life. Oh, he got his livelihood. And it made him feel so happy. And it made him feel so good. And he sang from his heart. Oh, sang from his soul.
Najiba.
Just made him whole. His friends kept working on him to try music out full time. Debut with rave reviews, a great career to climb. But finally they got to him, and he would take the fame. A concert agent in York agreed to have him sing, and there were plane tickets, phone calls, money spent to rent the hall. It took most of his savings, but he gladly used them all. It only took four lines, and no one could accuse them of being overkind. Mr. Martin Tanner, baritone of Dayton, Ohio, made his town hall debut last night. He came well prepared, but unfortunately his presentation was not up to contemporary professional standards. His voice lacked the range of tonal color necessary to make it consistently interesting. Full time consideration of another endeavor might be in order. He went home to Dayton and was questioned by his friends. Smiled and just said nothing. Never sang again.
Never sang again.
Except in very late at night, when the shop was dark and closed. He sang softly to himself as he sorted through the door.
Frank Walker, one. thing I should say, it was through Frank's efforts. I mentioned he's been incredibly helpful through all the years we've been doing this. Frank was the one that contacted Howard Fields and persuaded him to come up and join us. So I have an extra round of applause for Frank here. And we're going to bring out the...
Sang again. It excepting very late at night when his store was dark and closed. He sang softly to himself as he sorted through the clothes.
Flickering. day.